Okay guys, let's talk about something a lot of people take every single night thinking it's harmless, natural, and fixing their sleep. Melatonin. And I know this might sound controversial, but stick with me here. Melatonin kind of sucks for most people, and I'll explain exactly why. Not with opinions, but with actual biology and sleep science. Let's get straight into this, guys. All I ask from you is just to hit the like button down below. It tells YouTube this is what's showing to more people, so if you like learning about health from a scientific perspective in a calm and collected way, consider subscribing too. Melatonin is not a sleeping pill. That's the first thing you need to understand. Melatonin is a hormone your brain naturally releases from the pineal gland when it gets dark. Its job is not to knock you out. Its job is to tell your brain, hey, it's nighttime. Start shifting into night mode. That's it. It's a time cue, not a sedative. So when people take melatonin expecting it to work like sleep meds or magnesium, they're already setting themselves up for a disappointment. Here's where things really go wrong. Most over-the-counter melatonin supplements are massively mega-dosed. Your brain naturally produces melatonin in microgram amounts, like 0.1 to 0.3 milligrams. Meanwhile, most supplements on the shelf are 3 milligrams, 5 milligrams, and even 10 milligrams. That's 10 to 50 times more than what your brain ever sees naturally. And instead of improving sleep, high doses can actually fragment sleep, suppress REM, and make you feel groggy, anxious, or feeling hungover the next morning. And this is wild. Studies have shown that many melatonin supplements don't even contain what the label says. Some have far more melatonin than advertised, others less, and some even contain serotonin. So people say melatonin works sometimes, but in reality, they might be playing supplement roulette every night. Now let's talk about why melatonin often stops working after a few days or weeks. When you flood your system with high-dose melatonin, your brain can down-regulate its own melatonin receptors. Translation: your brain becomes less sensitive to melatonin over time. So people keep increasing the dose thinking, I guess I just need more, when in reality, they're making the problem worse. This is one reason people say melatonin used to work, but now it doesn't. Another big issue, melatonin can shift your circadian rhythm the wrong way. Timing matters a lot, and if you take melatonin too late at night or inconsistently, you could actually delay your internal clock instead of fixing it. That means later sleep onset, more nighttime awakenings, and that weird but tired feeling. This is especially common in people who already struggle with anxiety or nighttime racing thoughts. I know I've been there before. And let's talk about side effects, because no one mentions these. Melatonin can cause vivid dreams, nightmares, night sweats, headaches, dizziness, nausea, low blood pressure, and next day brain fog. It's quite a lot. Some people even experience increased anxiety, which sounds ironic for a sleep hormone, right? But it makes sense when you realize melatonin interacts with serotonin and dopamine pathways in the brain. Not a lot of people know that. Here's another underrated issue. Melatonin does nothing to fix the real reasons people can't sleep. If your sleep problems are caused by stress, cortisol dysregulation, which is huge, blood sugar crashes at night, caffeine too late in the day, poor light exposure, or an inconsistent sleep schedule, melatonin won't fix any of that. It's like putting a band-aid on a broken circadian rhythm and wondering why it keeps falling off. I wanted to take a tangent and add that melatonin timing is primarily set by morning light exposure, especially natural sunlight hitting your eyes, specifically the retina. When sunlight enters your eyes in the morning, it activates a group of cells called intrinsically photosensitive retinal ganglion cells, or your IPRGCs. These cells send a signal straight to your brain's master clock, the suprachiasmatic nucleus in the hypothalamus, and that signal does two critical things. It tells your brain it's daytime, which shuts off melatonin, and two, it starts a countdown timer for melatonin later on in the night. So you want to avoid artificial lights and get natural light early on in the day. Now, to be fair, melatonin does have very specific evidence-based uses. It can help with jet lag, shift work disorder, delayed sleep phase syndrome, and certain neurodevelopmental conditions. But for the average person taking it nightly because TikTok said it helps, that's where it fails, guys. So, okay, guys, what should you do instead? That's the big question, right? Focus on what actually drives melatonin naturally. Like I said, bright light exposure in the morning, dimming lights at night, consistent sleep and wake times, managing stress and cortisol, and avoiding late night screen time. Doom scrolling will mess your sleep up. If melatonin is used at all, remember that less is more, guys. But definitely those tips are what you really need to be honing in on. If you're gonna have to use melatonin, remember that less is more. We're talking 0.3 to 1 milligram, taking 2 to 3 hours before bedtime, not right as you're getting into bed. You could also do the alternatives that Dr. Huberman mentions that have worked well for others, magnesium threonate, L-theanine, apigenin, and glycine, just to name a few, which I left below for you as an affiliate should you wish to pick them up. So here's the bottom line. Melatonin doesn't knock you out. It doesn't fix poor sleep habits, and in high doses, it can actually make sleep worse. And if you know anyone who takes melatonin, go ahead and send them this video to help spread the news about it. If you learned anything though, hit that like button. It really does help support the channel and tells me you want more science-backed breakdowns like this one. And drop a comment if melatonin does work for you or completely wrecked your sleep. I want to hear both sides and both experiences. All right, guys, sleep smarter, not harder, and I'll see you guys on the next one.